Hi, it's Katrina. From scratching an itch to making their own weapons, here are 8 animals that use tools and are probably smarter than you think. Number 8, bears. Until 2012, there was very little evidence of tool use among mammals other than primates. In March of that year, the New Scientist reported that the year before, Volker Deecke of the University of Cumbria in the UK was visiting Glacier Bay National Park in Alaska when he spotted a brown bear taking a bath. Not just a regular bath, he even had his own barnacle-encrusted rock to use as a loofah to scratch its neck and muzzle. When brown bears molt, they get itchy, and these rocks help them to get off that loose fur. Bears are intimidating enough on their own. The thought of one wielding a weapon is utterly terrifying. In 1972, researchers heard of polar bears hitting a seal over the head with a chunk of ice, but so far no scientist has been able to witness that behavior in person. However, this little bear bath isn't scary at all. Volker Deecke argued in the journal Animal Cognition that the tool was an extension of the bear's natural exfoliation habits. He pointed out that the bear's behavior was most likely to relieve irritated skin or remove food particles from its fur in more or less the same way that a bear rubs against a tree trunk or another stationary object. There is a catch, however. Deecke continued on to say that the bear's use of a rock was indicative of sophisticated mental processes, in terms of both general intelligence and fine motor skills. This is a possible reason that bears have the largest brain relative to body size among all carnivores. Number 7. Coconut octopus. While it's common for marine invertebrates to hide opportunistically behind rocks and corals, using them as tools is practically unheard of. Amphioctopus marginatus, less formally known as the coconut octopus, was the first known species that gathers materials for its shelter and actually plans ahead. The 2-inch-long Indonesian cephalopod is known to gather discarded coconut shells and has even been observed swimming with them up to 50 feet, then arranging them on the ocean floor for later use. This behavior was first filmed in 2009 in North Sulawesi, Indonesia, by a team of biologists from the Museum Victoria in Melbourne, Australia. In the clip, one of the creatures is seen carrying 2 coconut shell halves along the ocean floor before stopping, pulling them together, and climbing inside. Julian Finn, the museum's curator for invertebrates and also the person who captured the act on film, considers the coconut carrying an example of tool use. Not all scientists are convinced, however. Marine biologist James Wood, for example, doesn't consider the use of a coconut shell as a house to constitute true tool usage. Instead, he believes that only when an object is used by an animal to interact with and change an environment is it truly a tool. Where do you draw the line when it comes to what constitutes tool use by an animal? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to know what you think. Number 6. Crows. Contrary to what many people think, crows are incredibly intelligent, even if they can be a bit creepy. Writer Kerr Than refers to them as the MacGyvers of the avian world, and for good reason. Crows use a variety of objects to make tools, including twigs, leaves, and even their own feathers. These tools are typically used for obtaining hard-to-reach food or for rooting insects out of dead wood. It's thought that crows acquire their tool-making skills through both nature and nurture. One study suggests that young crows are born with a propensity for making tools, but become truly proficient at it by watching their elders. When it comes to finding novel uses for everyday objects, crows from the Pacific island of New Caledonia, located to the east of Australia, are master toolmakers compared to crows in other parts of the world. Their skills rank them at the equivalent of chimps and second only to humans. These highly intelligent crows craft tools to specific needs. First, they identify a problem. Then they design an appropriate tool to remedy this problem. Birds on different parts of the island craft tools in slightly varying shapes, indicating the presence of a culture of tool technology that is on par with humans. This theory was put to the test by researchers from the University of Oxford, who raised 4 Caledonian crows, 2 of which were shown how to make tools, while the other 2 were not. All 4 crows ended up using sticks to retrieve other sticks from crevices for food, which helped scientists determine that they are, in fact, born with an innate ability to make and use tools. However, the 2 crows that received lessons on toolmaking were much more efficient and skilled at doing so. The insights gained from this research could be useful for studying how tool use evolved among humans. Besides all that, crows are very smart and can remember faces, so if you see one, be nice to it! And now for number 5. But first, Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. We have lots of new videos coming up. Plus, I'd love to have you here. Number 5. Capuchin monkeys. Crows aren't the only animals that researchers from the University of Oxford have been studying in recent years. In June of 2016, new findings were released. It turns out that monkeys residing in Brazil have been using stones to open cashews for an astounding 7 centuries. Lydia V. Luntz, one of the study's authors, believes that the stone-smashing activities of the capuchin monkeys probably goes back further than 700 years, stating the 1300s just happened to be the radiocarbon-dated time in the layers of soil in which the stone tools were found. We definitely expect this to go beyond 700 years. Michael Haslam, the lead author, previously wrote about archaeological evidence of macaques in Thailand using stone tools to split nuts and shellfish, meaning that the use of tools by primates is nothing new. This recent study in Brazil is, however, remarkable due to geography. It was the first of its kind to happen outside of Africa or Asia. Published in the journal Current Biology, the Oxford paper suggests the somewhat controversial idea that humans were actually influenced by watching monkeys use tools. The authors also speculate that the new arrivals to the New World learned that cashews were edible by watching the monkeys. I don't know, what do you guys think? Number 4. Elephants. The most commonly used tool among elephants is that of a branch as a fly swatter. Not only do these highly intelligent giants who have impressive memory spans pull branches from trees to keep bugs off their skin, they modify these branches to maximize the effectiveness of their use. One study which was conducted in India and consisted of 13 Asian elephants found that 8 of them modified branches for optimal use by stomping on the larger branches and ripping smaller, more appropriately sized ones off. In addition to elephants using makeshift back scratchers, some have been seen using stripped tree bark to plug small watering holes. This prevents the water from being drunk by other animals and from evaporating. In extreme cases, some especially aggressive elephants have used large rocks to breach electric fences. Pretty smart! Number 3. Orangutans. To understand how orangutans utilize branches, sticks, and leaves, picture the ways humans use screwdrivers, power drills, and other tools. These guys rely mainly on sticks as multi-purpose utensils, wielding them to pry insects out of trees or dig seeds out of fruit. They also use leaves as gloves for harvesting prickly plants, as umbrellas to shield themselves from the rain, or rolled up into tubes like megaphones for amplifying their calls. Orangutans in Borneo use bundles of leaves to make improvised whistles. When under a perceived threat, one will ward off predators by making a crude instrument that alters their calls, using leaves stripped from a twig. Because orangutans are somewhat solitary animals, they don't use distress calls. It would take too long for the nearest orangutan to respond to one. Instead, this kissing sound, made by a sharp intake of air through pursed lips, is not a distress call but is meant to make the threatening animal go away. Scientists weren't sure at first why orangutans used leaves when making this noise. One study suggested that the frequency of the kiss squeak was lowered by the use of the tool, which may make the orangutan sound bigger to its predator. According to study team member Madeline Hardis of the University of Utrecht in the Netherlands, an unaided kiss squeak from a bigger orangutan would have a lower frequency, suggesting the desire among smaller ones to make themselves sound bigger by artificially lowering the frequency of their calls with the leaves. Ta-da! Because the use of tools for enhancing the kiss squeaks was only observed among certain populations of orangutans, researchers perceive it as a sign of culture. And it's unlikely to be the last. Hardis stated, "I am absolutely sure we will find other forms of culture in orangutans and other primates. After decades of studying them, they keep on surprising us." Number 2. Bottlenose dolphins. Bottlenose dolphins are known for being one of the most intelligent mammals on the planet, so it's no surprise that they, too, have found utilitarian value in pieces of their environment. In 1997 in Shark Bay, Australia, scientists witnessed dolphins using basket sponges torn from the seafloor to cover their beaks before foraging for food. The tool protects their snouts from scrapes and stings and helps them uncover fish hiding in the sandy sea bottom. According to researchers, this behavior is seemingly passed from a mother to her daughter, and more than half of the area's males seem to then pick up the behavior. The behavior was traced back more than 180 years to a single dolphin nicknamed Sponging Eve, and scientists now believe that more than 60% of the Shark Bay dolphins practice sponging. Sponging was the first documented tool use among dolphins. Additionally, the dolphins at Shark Bay have been observed using conch shells to trap fish. And this is just what we've been able to observe, but seeing how the US and Russian military have been using dolphins for special missions, you know that these animals can do a lot more than that. Number 1. Chimpanzees. Just until a few decades ago, biologists believed that using tools was one thing that separated us from animals, but now it turns out all kinds of animals use tools. It should come as no surprise that humans' closest living relative has been reported to make and use tools. Not only that, but they have now started using stones and rocks as tools and passed down the information and behaviors from generation to generation, meaning that they have now entered a stone age of their own. On the Ivory Coast, stone hammers were found at a chimp settlement dating back some 4,300 years. While no chimpanzee remains were found at the site, the tools would have been too big for humans to use comfortably. This evidence, uncovered a little over a decade ago, revealed an especially important find: that chimpanzees learned how to make these tools on their own, rather than by copying humans. Until then, scientists believe that chimps learned how to make tools by observing local humans as they cut open their fruit. The archaeological findings, however, predate any farming that occurred in the area. This discovery indicates that humans and chimpanzees probably inherited at least some of their tool-using behaviors from a common ancestor. Modern-day chimps are known for their development and use of specialized tools for searching for food, foraging for termites, drinking, cleaning, and for crafting spears to hunt for food and other primates. Using stones as a tool to make other tools is pretty advanced. Scientists also observed chimps in Guinea, Africa using stone and wooden cleavers and stone anvils to pound open seeds and fruit. Chimps in Senegal were observed making spears and then hunting down smaller primates hiding in tree trunks. Chimps take four or more steps to make these hunting tools, and the younger generation is picking up on it and making it better. Kind of scary, right? Some of these findings, which have been shared pretty recently, prove that chimpanzees are even more intelligent than researchers originally thought. We may have underestimated the chimp, and the fact that they are now adapting different objects for various uses and building on complex information from one generation to the next means that chimps can now be considered practically a primitive culture. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe before you leave. See you next time. Bye!